Hi everyone, this is your favorite YouTuber, right? Anyways, today's episode, I'm going to show you how I shade and pick color for this particular painting. I mean, it looks nice, right? I'm trying to compliment myself here to make myself feel better. But I'm by no means an expert or a professional, but I still have opinions and information that I want to share to you, fellow artists. And I hope it will be helpful. So I started with a sketch, a really rough sketch. I started with a sketch of the features of the face first, and then I moved gradually outwards towards the jawline, the neck, and the hair. Now, reason why I do this is because I like doing it. Second is because it looked cool. I mean, you watched it, right? It looks cool. It looks like I know what I'm doing, even though I don't. But anyways, I'm thinking, okay, the reference is good and all, but I wanted to have my own color. So what about pink? I mean, pink looks good, right? I think so. Yeah, I've decided to use pink or purple as the color. So I have pink as the lighting source, and the purple, desaturated dark purple, for the shadows. You can see here I'm just testing color, but then I decided to have pink and purple. Now, it doesn't really matter what brush you use. You just use default hard round brush, it will be fine. Now, the thing about color is that, you know, you can use every color as a skin tone, granted of course if the environment fits it. Like, you can have really pink and purple face if you have your character is in like neon city light or something, so it will actually still work. I'm using normal mode because I like doing it. Nothing's fancy. But okay, the thing about color is that you should always have variation of color. You can't just have pink as the lighting source and then you have also pink as the shadow, because it will look really, really monotone and really bad. For the simple is bad. If you have no color variation, it will look bad. At least that's what I think I know. It's the same like drawing, painting anything. As long as there is variation of color, it makes the viewer feel as if there's something new in the painting, so that it will feel really good. Yes, that's how I explain it. But I'm going smaller and smaller in the brush to add details, like the eyes over here. So I'm just using even more dark and saturated color for the really crevices, for the really dark eye socket there, because I feel like that looks good. So I used it, and now it really doesn't matter what color you use as long as the value is correct. Doesn't mean it will look good, but when the value is correct and the color you pick are like random, it will still look good if the value is good. So here I'm trying to paint the background purple-ish so that it makes sense with the characters, so that my characters doesn't really look off, doesn't really look out of this world or something. So I added a desaturated purple for the background so that it fits well, and I added some red in the cheeks there. I added some red so that it's like blushy and it adds some color variation in it. Also, I added like secondary light from the left of the painting with cyan blue, really bright cyan blue, because again, color variation is really important in the painting. And to blend stuff, you need to have opacity, a pen tap perhaps. So you just paint it with really lightly and then pick the color lightly, pick the color. It's easy if you have a pen tap. If you don't, you need to buy one. Using Ibis Paint X is really hard. You need to actually have control over the opacity of your brush, okay? And so thank you so much for watching. I hope it will be helpful. I'm planning to do more real-time version of this, really long, so let me know what you think about that. So, but subscribe if you haven't already. I will be creating more contents frequently in the future. So yeah, bye.